So let's have a quick recap of the topic, and we had just now studied Malle's law. So from here, an unpolarized light is going to come like this, and this unpolarized light is going to fall on the polarizer, finally gets polarized. This is called a polarizer. This one is called analyzer. This intensity was I0. This intensity was I2 and this intensity was I1, and I told you that intensity I1 is twice of I0, so there is 50% reduction of the light when light energy, when it passes through the polarizer and becomes polarized. Now this I2 is equal to I1 cos square theta, where theta is the angle between optic axis of A and B, correct? Or it is the angle over here between BN, optic axis BN, E0. So how would you identify whether the light is polarized or not? So for that I have a very beautiful animation. Just look. See, this is an polarized light. And that means in this wave, all the vectors would be aligned in this particular direction. Now this optic axis of the polarizer, say this is polarizer, or let's call this as an analyzer. Now the optic axis of analyzer and E vector are parallel, so the light is going to pass through and on the screen you will get light. Now I am going to rotate this by 90 degrees, so the A comes over here. Look, so I have rotated this polarizer and A was initially here, so I had turned A by 90 degrees, so optic axis was being turned by 90 degrees. Now optic axis is perpendicular to the principal axis, so sorry, the optic axis, so this E0 vector, it is not going to come out. Or you can apply Malle's law that the vectors that come out should be E0 cos theta, but theta is 90 degrees because the angle between the E0 and the vector or the optic axis is 90 degrees, so this is going to be 0. So if this E0 vector comes over here like this, its component along this optic axis is 0, so no light is obtained on the screen. Again, if I turn A by another 90 degrees, so that means by 180 degrees from the beginning like this, B comes up, so now E0 vector can pass through and again you will see the light on the screen. In the same way, earlier A was over here, then we had turned it by 90 degrees, another 90 degrees, so A reached over here, now another 90 degrees, so total turning of this is 270 degrees. So here again this E0 vector will not be able to pass and you will not get any light on the screen. Finally, 360 degrees, so A was being rotated completely by 360 degrees and you will see light on the screen. So what did you just notice, people? That if I rotate this polarizer, sorry, analyzer by 360 degrees, two times you will get light on the screen and two times the intensity will be zero. So if you are given, suppose if this is some light, we don't know whether it is polarized or unpolarized light. If you are having an analyzer or a simple tourmaline crystal, if you turn this by 360 degrees and on the screen if you get two times light and if you don't get two times light, that means this incoming light is polarized. Because if the light is polarized, then and only then this can block the light at 90 degrees and at 270 degrees, because at that time it would be in this position. The optic axis and the vectors would be perpendicular, so no light on the screen. Now imagine if we are dealing with an unpolarized light. Sorry, this is unpolarized light. Now in unpolarized light, you may wish to turn this by 360 degrees, but you will always get the light on the screen. And why it is so? Because right now in this position, these vectors are going to pass through. If you make this like this, then these vectors are going to pass through because there are all kind of vectors. So if you even turn this by 360 degrees, there will be some component of, or there will be some vectors which will be parallel to the optic axis and you will get the light on the screen. So how will you identify whether the light is polarized or unpolarized? You have to pass the light through a polarizer or a simple tourmaline crystal, and that too in a rotating way. So you have to rotate this tourmaline crystal by 360 degrees, and if you always get light on the screen, it is unpolarized. But if you get 2 times maximum and 2 times minimum, then that light is polarized.